In this video, we will present how police investigations are revolutionized thanks to the powerful temporal and geospatial analysis features of Hume. We can find data quickly in our knowledge graph through our search bar, in this case, a crime that we want to investigate by its ID. We then view that node on the canvas and can view its properties as the date that it takes place, 5th of August 2017, or explore connections with only a few clicks to check where it took place and who lives there. We can see the data on a map thanks to geospatial analysis. And we can empower our investigation with Hume actions, pre-canned cipher queries that we can run with a simple click. In our case, the action allows us to find resources near the crime scene from which we can derive information to solve the case. When we click it, it asks for input from the user, which will be the radius around the cursor that gets examined to return results. We get in purple cell phone towers and in grey plate camera readers. We check the cell phone data from the cell tower that is closest to the crime scene and expand the cell phones back to the canvas. We want to find cell phones that appear in the area in question at the date of the crime, 5th of August 2017. Thus, we utilize temporal analysis. We see the time bar below with the distribution of the cell phone pings over time and focus on the date of the crime to filter out unwanted connections. So we double-click in August to quickly narrow down our investigation to 4 cell phones. Band the phone's owners and we see one belongs to a deceased person, which is highly suspicious, apparent from the different styling of the node, and we can confirm in the properties that the person has a DOD, date of death, just the day before the crime. So we focus our investigation on this cell phone and delete the rest. We get the other pings of the phone and we want to correlate its location over time through our data. We enable geospatial analysis again to view it on the map. The correlation is made possible thanks to the auto-refresh action that is run every time we shift the time bar. So let's have a look at how the position of the phone changes on the map over time. On the map with yellow, we have the position of the cell phone and we can see that it moves to the same positions as the cell towers. This creates a cluster of nodes indicated by the number in the middle and the colors indicate how many nodes of each type exist in that cluster. We can see that as the time approaches that of the crime, the location of the phone also approaches the crime scene. So, thanks to Hume, we were able to do solid, intelligent analysis of our data and empower our investigation without having any technical knowledge or write any code. Thank you for watching. If you found this video insightful, why not take a look at hume.graphaware.com to learn more about the power of graphs and Hume.